in this video, we are going to analyze the CM1 September 2019 paper. So we will just take up the numerical sums and we'll try to type it down into the word. So the first two questions in the paper were theory questions, like direct theory questions. You can just type it down in word. The next question, the third question, the first part again was a theory question with a normal typing explanation of 2 marks. The second part was a numerical question, so I'll just show you all the question. It states that 2 lives, each aged exactly 40, are independent with respect to mortality and are each subject to a constant force of mortality of 0.01 per annum. Calculate the value of this expression in part 1. So the expression in part 1 over here, we need to calculate this, and it's of 4 marks. So we'll in this video type it down. This is the example which I have already written. So this is the first way of solving it by using the equation. The second way is again to use the integral and solve it. So we'll try to type it down both of these in this class. So let's begin. What I'll do is, with for my reference, I'll keep the answers to my left. So this is the answer which I have, and I'll type it down in the word in the right hand side. So there are 2 ways to do so. I can use the editor or the equation editor, or you can simply use the notations over here. For some cases, we will have to use the mathematical equation editor, but you can obviously do it without as well. So I'll just state both the ways to do over here. So let's begin to get the mathematical editor equation. What we do is we click on alt equal to, which gives us the equation editor. You can just click on in here and change it to inline, so it just shifts to the left. Also, we have 5-17. Now this can be written in 2 ways. What you can do is you can just simply write 5-17, and then you can write Q and you can move ahead. But in doing this, what can happen that there can be a little confusion, but then it will be fine, because this is the notation which is given by the IFOA, as this is the desired, this is a suitable alternative for writing this. Now I'll also show you all as to how you can write this using the structures in the equation tab which opens up. So here we have caret 1 for the 1 in the superscript, and then I'll give a underscore 40 and I'll hit space again, click on left arrow to move down, colon 40. So this is my, just click on the right arrow and you move out of the equation. Equal to, we have 1/2, and then for the multiplication, again as given by the IFOA, you can use the star, but here as we are within the equation editor, so I'm just preferring to use the times. If you all have seen my previous 3 classes, you all know these shortcuts by now. So the next way to write this down, I'll show you all, is by using the structures in the equation tab over here. So I'll use structures, and we'll use this particular structure which you see. Now in case of this, we'll write 5-17, and in here will be our Q, again underscore 40 space, just left arrow, colon 40. So here for this box, to remove this box, you can just type in space and you can remove the box given. I'll increase the size a bit, so it's fine. Now moving on to the next line, again I'll get my equation editor, alt equal to, and here then we type equal to, we have this entire thing 1/2, then we have again the times, and we use the first bracket. We have this thing 5p40. So what we can do is, instead of writing it down again, I can just copy this statement and paste it over here, and I can just change in the values. So this is 5, and you just need to click on this make sure only Q is highlighted and I'll write a capital P. So why I'm writing a capital P? Because it becomes noticeable. If you write a small p, it will be fine, but still, if you write a capital P, then it becomes noticeable. 1 minus, again I'll paste it down. And what you could have done, instead of pasting this, let me do one thing, let me copy this and paste it over here again, right? So we have 5, instead of 5 we'll have, so make sure you're using your left arrow key efficiently. Right arrow, and so that you do not have to use the mouse again and again, right? 5. So that's your complete equation. Right arrow and you close the brackets. Moving on to the next line, get my equation editor back, alt equal to, and again I'll type the same thing, 1 by 2 bracket, and we have this. So again you can paste it down, so I'll just click on Control V. We have, instead of this over here, so I'll remove this, and before this I'll write, let me remove this entire thing, and we have P caret 2 underscore 40, right? And then what we can do, we can again copy this thing and paste it over here instead of typing it all over again. So instead of 5 we should have, I'll use left arrow, 22, right? Use the arrow keys a lot within the equation tab because it helps a lot. This is done, then we have to give the formula for TPX. So I'll write, and for TPX what you can do is you can just simply write T capital P and X. So this can also be done, or you can again use the equation editor, it's up to you, doesn't matter because they accept both the things. So I have simply wrote TPX because this will save some time. So wherever you know that you are able to save time, you need to proceed in that particular manner. Now again here we have e to the power, so for that we'll use caret minus, and for integral I'll use int. For top we'll write caret t underscore 0, and then we have mu, so again I'll use a backward slash, mu underscore, we have x. Give a space and then click on the left arrow to move down and write plus s, and then again the right arrow, move out of the equation and write ds. Close the bracket, hit space, and you have the entire thing with yourself. Now what I'll do is I'll copy this thing because I'll need this in my next line. Click on enter, equal to, paste it over here, and then within this I'll just use the left arrow again. This is not required. Instead of this, what is required? 0.01, right? Again, I'll move to the next line. Tab and tab equal to Control V and left arrow. Use left arrow very nicely because then we have 0.01 T. So this is my TPX. Again, I can move down and I can now copy this entire thing again. So I'll copy and paste it over here and change the intending. That I'll do later. Let me just equal to, and we have this entire statement again. So 1 by I'm so sorry for this, just a second. 1 by 2 first bracket, then again we have e to the power minus 0.05 bracket close caret 2 space minus. Again what you can do is you can copy this entire thing down and then just change the number. So I'll just change the number, instead of 5 it's 0.22, and you click on right arrow, close the bracket. Move to the next line, change the indenting if you want to, change it to inline, and then again we get the equation editor. This can be done without getting the equation editor itself. So what you can do is, instead you can write 0.5 here, or you can write 1 by 2 and then proceed by writing it in the bracket. So both can be done. I'm using this instead of using my equation editor. This will save me some time. 83574 minus 0.660364. The more you practice, the more your speed increases. 0.13040. So this is my final answer. Moving on and doing it in the next way, which is I think the shorter way. So obviously in exam you'll prefer doing it in one way itself. I'll just show you the next method also as to how we can proceed. Now again we need the equation editor for this, or according to the IFOE notations you can use this and you can write int and then the lower limit and the upper limit. So that can be done. Let me just in this class use the equation editor because I consider it to be easier. If you want, you can use obviously the notations, and we'll have more recordings on how to use that as well. Here we'll just write int and 22 as the upper limit and lower limit as 5. Then the TPX can again be written as T capital P and underscore 40. This can be done. Or you can again use the structures. In structures you can use this particular thing which we used in our above equation, right? Moving on, we then have again the same thing, capital P and underscore 40. Then we have mu 40, just give space, right arrow again, left arrow plus t, right arrow dt, right? And then moving on to the next line, get the equation editor back, equal to, what you can do is you can just copy this thing because we have the integral same. So I'll just copy paste it over here, and the equation within the integral will be e to the power minus 0.02t space, and you get it on top. Then click on the right arrow to move out, 0.01 this way, and then again moving on to the next line, you can get this within the equation editor or without the equation editor, both. So I'll use the equation editor one, alt equal to, and then we have 1 by 2 bracket open e to the power minus 0.02t space, close the brackets and the limits. Fine, change it to inline if you want to, and if you want to keep it in middle, doesn't matter much, right? Moving on, this can again be without or with the notations. With the notations, you'll just have to write exp in bracket, you'll write, or you can write to the power minus 0.1, right? You can do that as well. So in here I'll use the equation editor again. You can use this also. Let me do one thing, let me copy paste this thing. So I'll write equal to 1 by 2, copy paste it, and in here instead of the numbers will change definitely, minus control V, and we have 0.44 close bracket, change it to inline, and the final answer is 0.13040. So this is how you can solve this equation. This is a 4 marks. This is a 4 marks, so it should not take more than 4 minutes or maximum 5 minutes, maximum 5 to 6 minutes to solve this. I've showed you all both the ways as to how we can solve this particular sum. In our coming classes, we'll be solving all the sums in this paper. And if you all have any queries, you can post it down in the comment section below. Thank you so much.